Hey Maplers, Coppersan here. In this video, we're taking a look at all three Explorer Archers and their 5th job skills. What Archer you want to be only depends on one thing really. What color would you like your bird to be? A black shadowy raven, then pick Pathfinder. A fiery red phoenix, then pick Bowmaster. Or a blue frozen phoenix, then pick Marksman. Let's start off with the freshest of all Archers, the Pathfinder. The most flashy of all three bowmen. Released only last year in 2019, this class uses a special relic that needs to be filled in order to use certain skills. Pathfinder's main attacking skills are Cardinal Burst and Cardinal Deluge, I think that's how you pronounce it. Cardinal Burst is a second job skill that hits 4 enemies 4 times with 200% damage. However, this skill gets buffed in 3rd job and 4th job, so in the end it hits 6 enemies 4 times with 300% damage per line. Cardinal Deluge is a 1st job skill that hits 4 enemies 4 times with 90% damage, but like the other one, this skill also gets buffed during your 2nd and 4th job, hitting 6 enemies 4 times with 200% damage, plus you'll fire an additional arrow if you're bossing. Now, usually Pathfinders put both skills in a macro and then you're basically good to go for the rest of your adventure. Most other skills that do damage have cooldowns and are dependent on the energy stored in your relic. But that ain't all. The relic has different emblems as well. Depending on which emblem is active, some skill effects might change. Using your skills also lowers the cooldown of these skills, so you can just keep on using them, or at least with a very short cooldown if you're attacking. In 4th job, Pathfinder gets a skill called Curse Weaver, which also allows them to put a curse on enemy monsters when using those skills. Your character will deal up to 20% more critical damage at max stack, so when you're bossing, it's useful to just spam all these skills first, get the curse stack up to max, and then you start attacking with your cardinal skills. As always, there are 3 new skills to learn in 5th job. The first one is Nova Blast. This skill can delete monsters even faster than Nexon can delete fun content. Exploding the entire map with 2100% damage to 15 enemies, and it hits 15 times as well. It does consume all your relic energy though, and it deals more damage depending on how much energy you have built up. And to top it off, you're also invincible while casting. Then there is Raven Tempest, which is your Shadow Raven creating a tornado by, I don't know, flapping its wings like some kind of Pokemon. The direction of the skill can be changed if you press the skill button again, and the Tempest itself lasts 12 seconds and deals 420% damage, which is an acceptable number, against 12 enemies 5 times. And finally, Obsidian Barrier. The effect of this barrier changes depending on which relic emblem is active. It can, for example, nullify all damage in a certain area, deal damage, or create a personal shield for you and your party member that reduces the damage of attacks that deal a fixed percentage of damage, and stuff like that. When Pathfinders were released, they were really, really strong. However, Nexon did make them a bit weaker over time. Overall, they're still a strong class, which you can definitely main if you want to, but they have fallen off a little bit when it comes to dealing damage. But still, a pretty good class overall. And then we have Marksman. This Explorer Archer probably has the worst mobbing out of all three, but it is making up for it with some of its 5th job skills, and high damage as well. Marksmen have a few passive skills which impact their playstyle. For example, in 2nd job there is Rangefinder, which increases the ignore defense rate if you're closer to an enemy, and the further away you are, the more final damage you'll do. In 4th job there is a similar skill called Vital Hunter. This skill also increases the enemy defense ignored if you're further away from the enemy. Marksman's main mobbing skill is Piercing Arrow. This skill deals 400% damage against 6 enemies 5 times. Final damage is increased by 15% for every enemy that is pierced, and the damage is doubled. It doesn't have a lot of vertical range though, so horizontally it's pretty nice, but vertically it just, the range is almost non-existent. And then there is Snipe, which does a whooping 730% damage 5 times, ignores 20% defense, and has 100% critical rate. This skill has a 5 second cooldown though, so it can't be spammed until you get cooldown reduction from your hyper skills. Marksman mobbing is quite lackluster, but this completely changes in 5th job. Marksman get a really nice skill called Split Shot, and this skill splits your attacks up, dealing 624% damage to 10 enemies 5 times. This is a buff skill that you can use every 120 seconds, and it lasts for 60 seconds. So for 1 minute, you'll be blowing up stuff like crazy. Arrow Split gives Marksmen their attack more vertical range as well, which is really nice. It's a shame that buff duration doesn't apply to 5th job skills, because I would love to have this skill active like always. Marksmen get another really unique 5th job skill called Perfect Shot. This skill turns the entire map in that Fritto minigame where you have to shoot those birds. MapleStory basically turns into Call of Duty 20 and you get to shoot up some monsters, dealing 1248% damage at level 1 to 12 enemies, and it hits 9 times. It ignores 100% of the enemy defense, and your character will become invincible for 2 seconds after casting. Man, this skill is so broken, even the familiar system is getting jealous. And their third skill is Surge Bolt. This is a charge skill that can be held down while using your other attacking skills. Once the skill is charged, it can be unleashed, dealing 520% damage against 10 monsters 10 times. And if the charge is completed, the skill will instead deal 780% damage. It also ignores 50% of the enemy defense and has an additional 100% crit rate. Thanks to their strong 1v1 skills with snipe and high skill damage percentages, marksmen make for some pretty good bosses. Even with 100k range, you'll be easily dishing out damage in the millions. By the way, if you are enjoying this video, don't forget to smash that like button and subscribe for more content. And finally, Bowmasters. Overall, I would say Bowmasters are pretty balanced and stable, unlike some other things. Bowmasters use the arrow quiver to boost their attacks with additional effects such as healing, poison, or shooting an additional magical arrow. In third job, the archers get a skill called Arrow Blaster, which has actually quite a big impact on their playstyle. This skill can be placed down as a turret, so you can clear multiple parts of the map at the same time. This class is a pretty good mobber overall. Your main attacking skills are Arrow Stream, which deals 350% damage to 8 monsters 5 times, and Hurricane, which is a skill that you can hold down to fire off a continuous stream of arrows. You can also move while casting the skill, it's pretty nice. The skill deals 350% damage per arrow, but there is a hyper skill that lowers the damage, but your character will fire an additional arrow. For fifth job, Bowmasters get a skill called Storm of Arrows. This skill rains down arrows for 41 seconds, and it procs every 5 seconds, and up to 6 of these arrow rain areas can be created. This skill does 624% damage up to 10 enemies 5 times, and it's a really nice boost for your overall DPS. Then there is Inhuman Speed, which only lasts for 3 seconds, firing arrows at an interval dealing 416% damage 3 times to enemies within range. Now that might not sound that awesome, but like a 3 second skill, but when the skill is on cooldown, you'll create after images every 10 attacks that proc the skill again. The cooldown for this attack is 30 seconds, so technically you could be using this skill forever and just have additional damage. It's a nice skill that increases your burst damage, and I was actually hoping for something like an assassin-like afterimage, but it's just the blue effect that you see pop up every now and then. But when using Hurricane, you attack super fast, so every 10 attack procs really fast, and it's pretty nice when bossing. And finally there is Quiver Barrage, which allows you to use all type of arrowheads at once, increasing your attack power by 5%, and it launches 6 special flaming arrows, hitting a max of 6 enemies for 780% damage 3 times. This skill lasts 30 seconds. The downside of attacking so many times so quickly is that before you know damage inflection is activated, you already have like 100 hits in, so yeah, I died. Maybe not the best example of bossing from my side. But overall, the Explorer Archers are pretty cool and they have really unique playstyles. And that's it for today. What classes should we do next? Many thanks to our members for making this video possible. Thanks to Quinn, Niels de Koning, Ramawar, Zenny, Chen125, Rafferim, Krauker, The Purple Flurp and Proxys Gaming. If you would like to be mentioned here as well and get early access to new videos, check out the join button below this video. Thanks for watching, stay safe, and happy mapling!